stage, isn't that right? Some of you might recognize this guy. Yeah, you're gonna see some familiar faces, some odd-looking faces, and some faces that may have aged just a little bit from the last time you saw him out here on the water. So please be a little bit patient with us tonight as we go through that. You actually may see some wetsuits that don't fit as well as they used to fit. I'm looking down there at you, well, Paul,
we're looking right at you, Paul. Right at you. And we all know it's not the wetsuit. However, of all the faces that are familiar, not familiar, new and old, there are over 50 years some faces that will not be seen anymore on this water.
Yes, and so we'd like to take a quick moment to remember some of our friends that we've lost over the past 50 years. So if we could just have a brief moment of silence, please. As we think about our friends, thank you for that.
And a huge round of applause for 50 generations of Aquanauts on the water in front of you. We're about to start in just a minute.
Like watching the film, this juggle this stuff right up. There you go. Hey, get this guy up here, would you? Are you just trying to help him up? Yeah! Okay, this is gonna be interesting. It's kinda looking like we got a little problem getting this guy out of his boat. Here we go. Oh man, it's like a beached whale. Okay! Oh, Jerry! Was it part of the script? I don't think so! Alright, come on over here. Get up here, let's go. Hey, they're having this show. We gotta keep going here, so let's talk about something. Let's talk about how much we got in trouble. We forgot his lines. We haven't even started yet. Hey. So, hey, do you remember when we used to get in all kinds of trouble here? Yeah, what were we doing? We were stealing the boat and giving, like, that stuff and all the things. Yeah. And then the announcer would say, you guys are in so much trouble. And what would we say? We are too. Okay, hey. Hey. Still stupid? Yeah. Yeah, we are. Oh, no, seriously. You know what? We had so much fun when we were doing all these naughty things. If we could just go back in time, wow! That would be awesome. Yeah, they cost a lot of money, I'm sure. Yeah, but boy, we'd just go have so much fun. It was so much fun over there. Yeah. So, hey, what are we going to do if we only had a time machine? Anybody know when there's a time machine? Behind us? You want us to turn around? Okay, turn around. Let's see if we can turn around here. Whoa! Okay, whoa! Hey, let's go backwards. Whoa! I'm turning around. Whoa! Okay, hey. We didn't see any time machine. What? It's where? Oh, geez, it's around! There's a time machine there. Hey, why don't we start the time machine? What do you think? No, you push the button. No, push the button. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Aquanaut Water Shows. 50 years in the making. Glad you're joining us tonight. Very special night for all of us, bringing all these skiers back, boat drivers and assistants, rope and dock crews. We're here from day one. What's with this guy? Hey, let's go through. What are you doing up there? Going the wrong way, this way. But anyhow, we're going to start with the original app we start all of our shows and tournaments with, which is a flag line. Way back in the day, the girls would go out with their flag lines, and we've got some girls. Here's our boat opening first. The power of the Aquanauts. We're proud to say we've had many national championship boat drivers through the years and to this very day. They can hear you. Let's give them a round of applause. So the water skiing gods are shining down on us tonight. Look at this weather and the water conditions. It's amazing. We're loving it. So anyhow, tonight we've got a great group of skiers. I've got a great group of announcers and a great group of boat drivers. You can see the Hydrodyne boats. Oh my gosh, these guys are phenomenal.
Out there in those boats, that was Ron Bergsma, Buster Amor, Bob Kohler, and Todd Wren.
Some of the best in the business, folks. Again, a bunch of these skiers have not skied together some 30, 40 years. But they practiced a little bit this week, so be patient. I guarantee you they're going to give you the best effort they can, and we'll put on a good show. The line's going out now. Rope's getting taut. They're bringing the power up their boat. The girls getting set and ready.
Hey, Bobby, this flag line is one of the original acts of Aquanaut Water Shows from back in 72, isn't it?
It was, it's first one. And ladies and gentlemen, one of my announcers tonight, Mr. Mike O'Shea. Give it up for Mike O'Shea.
What a crowd. This is huge. I don't know if I've ever seen a crowd this large here for a show. Thank you all for coming out. We really appreciate it.
Hey, Mike, you want to tell them who else is announcing tonight with us? Who we've got on hand?
We've got several announcers through the 50-year history of the Aquanaut Water Shows. Like I said, original announcer, Mr. Robert O'Neill. We've got Brian Walmsley from the 90s.
Brian Walmsley, give it up.
80s representative, Brian, take a bow. Thank you. We've got Mike Thornton up here helping us out. We've got Larry Anderson in from Florida. He was the announcer in 1982 when the Wisconsin State Show Tournament was won by the Aquanauts and their first ever national title.
Okay, we're getting ready, folks. Direct your full attention to the left side of the show course as the girls come through with the Aquanaut Flag Parade. With our opening act for the beginning of our ski shows in 1972.
People play around with lots of hoops and hollers. They can hear you out there.
Sneak in there.
I think that's a collective age equivalent of 487 years of Aquanaut experience.
I think so. You have to come and have a shot the ring snow for sure, though. DJ Calver snuck in there.
Right now, up on the show here, we've got three generations of skiers from two different families, the Westerlands and the Amors. Hang on, everybody.
Well, Sherry started with us in 72.
And Sherry's son, Andy, who you may have come down to hear announce over the years at ski, is out there on the water as well, as is their son, Parker. So we've got three generations of that family.
You know, it's amazing. Sherry started with the original Aquanauts. Before it was the Aquanauts, it was actually the Twin Lakes ski team in the early 70s. And came through later as the change of the Aquanauts and moved to the show site. Anyhow, so let's welcome them back in.
We
possible appearance.
Give it up for him. What a great job. So I said Cindy was with us when we first started the Aquanauts, but before it was the Aquanauts, it was a Twin Lakes ski team. And we did our shows in front of the old Edgewater Motor and down by Snack Shack. We moved to this site in 1972 and became the Aquanaut Water Shows. Great job, you guys.
Nice job, guys. Thank you very much. It's really cool when you see 50 years of skiing on the water all at the same exact time. But in the last 50 years, we've learned to do things not only on the water, but high over the water, incorporating that funny little thing right out in the center of the stage. That thing goes 5.5 feet high, and it is called a ramp. Now, Aquanauts over the years coined a little term for our jumpers. We called them, wow, you aren't kidding, you guys go everywhere. They're called Grandmasters. They go over the water, but if you look down to the left, you have guys who throw them high above the water. Indeed, one of the most photographed of ski history is the pyramid. As I said, we like to kind of take things over the water too. And in fact, one guy for many, many years on the water, next to the water, there we go, Mike. His name is Michael Thornton. I'm going to bring him here. Come on, Mike.
You look good up there.
We might need to use this microphone.
You can be permanent up there.
We're fine. We'll share this one.
Yeah, this will work. Mic check, Mike. See if that. It might be my voice.
Mic check. Mic check.
See, once you get old, even the mic's die. Look, he's kind of in the right now, Mike.
How about this, folks?
There you go, right?
You gotta relearn how to bring that girl in. Let's get them all up here on stage. They're a little sore, and now they might be a little more sore. Let's welcome back an alumni opening pyramid.
Good job. Where there was one, there is one more. What's coming in from the left, Mike?
How about one more pyramid down to the left-hand side? We've got a double top, two high pyramid. There's some more of our alumni looking good.
The pyramid just isn't that it goes up. Little inside information, the hardest part of every pyramid isn't going up. It's what direction, Mike?
It's taking them down.
And why is that?
Well, every step out there is critical. And when you haven't done this for a few years, to slide that girl down on the front of your skis is also very difficult because obviously now you have two people on those skis versus one. And then the thing to do is you never want to body slam your girl as they come in. So let's see if these two guys out there that got girls on the front of their skis, if you can bring them in safely this time.
It's amazing how graceful we are on the water, but as we get closer to shore, the wheels start to fall off just a little bit.
Let's welcome back our second alumni opening pyramid team.
Good job. Now, there will be a show within the show. And it's more of a little comedy element, in case you haven't picked up on what it is yet. This surface right here
that goes along here is the slickest surface in this entire show site, including the water. So enjoy, because every water ski, ourselves included. But when we get back here, we gotta somehow get from there to here without sliding back down. And it isn't easy.
So it looks like we got two jumpers, two alumni jumpers. Looks like, from my eyesight, that's Chris Cadera. And is that Mike?
It is Mike Wisniewski.
Mike Wisniewski, yes. We're going to do our best with some of the names tonight. We'll try our hardest. Looks like we've also got some more. These guys look a little bit like they've hit the jump more recently.
I like Anthony Wright. Is that an Anthony Wright? Yes, we have Anthony Wright.
That is, well, it looks like Anthony's going first by himself. So this is Anthony Wren.
By the way, cool with a fact. Anthony Wren is behind the boat, but Mike, who's driving the boat?
I believe that would be his father, Todd Wren.
So you alumni folklore, many of you like Todd Wren, I saw him going over the jump. But now Todd's driving at the jump while he's pulling who at the jump?
That would be his son, Anthony. So we'll keep our eyes on him. Todd, one of the most accomplished alumni jumpers back in the day. Anthony, he's picked this up over the last couple of years. Not sure if he's throwing his head back or going forwards or what it's doing. I believe he's doing a front flip, right? Keep your eyes on Anthony with the gainer, Mr. Anthony Wren.
Boom! All the way around, upside down, 360 degrees backwards. Now, we kind of got a number game we're going to play here, and this is going to go back into folklore of Aquanaut history. See, there's two guys sitting there. Then there's a girl, her name is Cynthia Van Cleef. Hi, Cynthia. Oh, we got, wait, look to the right. Two guys, oh, I forgot about your mic. Check. Tell jumping ahead of myself. What's happening now, Michael? Cynthia Van Cleef?
Well, right now, since they crashed, we're going to have the slowest quick pick in the history of the Aquanauts.
And as long as we have a little time here, this, you guys, you've never seen this before, some of you have, in all the world, in all the show skiing ever, this next trick you're about to see was invented right here on this lake. Might sound simple, but it's actually really hard. What is it, Mike?
We're going to crack the whip and link these guys up, I believe. Except for the other boat's not coming. At all.
They say the memory is the first thing to go.
They're not coming at all, guys. Here they come.
Wait.
Slow it down, Todd, slow it down. This could be the best whip in the history of the Aquanauts. We're going to crack the whip. We're going to link these guys up. We're going to see how you guys put the some of these guys have not jumped in quite some time, so I don't think we have all four going off together. But I think we do have those two guys in the middle. They are wrapping up. The two guys on the outside, they're patting their heads. That means they're going to split the middle. Double helicopter, double split.
Sit here and watch, and as a former jumper, one of the craziest things in the world is to be looking up and seeing a pair of skis spinning right over your head, and you're thinking in that moment, please, for the love of whoever's running this show, don't come down on my head. And then they splat right next to you, and you look at each other and you're like, sweet.
How about this? Our first two guys, they did a great job out there on the water. And these four guys coming back as well. We'll go from left to right. While we get these guys up, we got
one of the best whips I've ever seen.
Better late than never. Now, we don't just like to perform on the water body. Sometimes we have to interject a little bit of humor in every show, don't we?
Well, we've had the craziest group of clowns here forever. Some of them aren't even in the act. A lot of clowns part of this book. So, but let's look at the main show here, folks. These guys are invading our space. Hey, what are you guys doing out there? Hold it. We got a ski show going on here. Please get off the pier. Wait a minute. No. You're supposed to be on later. This is another act supposed to be on right now, not you guys. Get off the pier, please. You're driving me crazy, folks. Let's see what they're up to.
Hey, we want to go skiing.
No, you're not going skiing.
Yeah, we are.
No, you are not going skiing. The ski show, we got a little bit of time. We can't fit you into the schedule.
Well, we're doing nothing out here, so we might as well go skiing.
It's all about nothing? Is that what you're all about?
Yeah! We've been doing nothing all day!
Wait a minute.
Whoa! It's not
me! It's me! God, this sounds like thunder!
Ah, this is print time here! Hey, this reminds me. Uh-oh.
Is that a phone ringing?
Boys and girls.
Whose phone is ringing? Someone. Is there a phone somewhere?
Hey! I hear a phone!
Yeah, I'm not sure. Oh, wait, is it? Is there a little angel? Believe me, a little angel. Ladies and gentlemen, beautiful angel, a heavenly angel. Oh, my God.
Uh-oh, folks.
I don't like the looks of this at all. I think it's assignment from God to build an ark, and they got the dimensions, and I think they're going to use that as the ark. So let's just keep an eye on it and see what they do. You never want to irritate the man above, and they've done it. These clowns have irritated him for 45 years, almost 50. Well, all right. Now, what are you going to do? You rather take the ark? Why would you take a baseball bat out to an ark for a ski jump? I don't get it. Well, we'll just give it a little ride and bring it back in. Now, what's this guy going to do? Come on. Well, it's a soul of grace. The Lord is with you. Don't die. Oh, boy.
He made it up.
Now, what's going on out here? That's pretty slow boat speed to go for the ski jump. Just wait, get away from the jump. No, no, don't come near the jump. Get away, get away. You're going too slow. Wait, that's not how you go for a ski jump. Well, this is not how you jump, people. Just saying. Well, okay, so we've got one skier up there, one clown up there, with jump skis and a baseball bat. That doesn't sound like a good thing when another one's out here in the water and it might come back this way. Oh. And aren't they getting those skis off? Well, look out, because you got company coming any minute there, clowning. All right, one ski's off. One more. All right, come on, clowning. What are you going to do with that baseball bat? Well, you're going the wrong way in the jump. You're going the wrong way. Hold on. Here comes your partner. Looks like batting practice might be happening in a minute here. Hold on. Take a quick circle. You want to go up here? You want to go there? Okay. Where's the rescue squad? Please be ready. This doesn't look like it's going to turn out well, okay? Two people that obviously don't know how to ski and obviously don't know how to jump are behind these boats right now. One on top of the jump with a baseball bat. So here we go. Looks like batting practice at Lance Park, folks. Here we go. And the big swing. Ladies and gentlemen, the Aquanaut Clowns. Back in the day, the Aquanaut Clowns, it's not even much part of show skiing anymore, but back in the day, the original Aquanaut Clowns, Jeff Slovak, Kevin Upper, Greg Borowski, the judges would go crazy. Every time they pulled their little stunts, they'd go nuts. So we got a great history of some of the best clowns in the nation. Actually, years later, Kenny Borowski won the water skiing Hall of Fame for that comment. Down in Central Stratum, somewhere in Florida. Anyhow, we'll hand it up to some of the compadres. We'll keep the flow going.
Much of it. All right, this next act is really kind of cool because it's environmentally friendly. But one thing I want to talk about before we get to this next act, one of the coolest things that Aquanauts introduced to show skiing that is all behind the scenes is the actual show element of show skiing. I want to tell you about that really in a little bit because right now MT is going to direct your attention to the right hand side.
Take a look down to the right hand side right now. Yes.
Wilder's out there.
Wilder's walking on the water. These guys are
using the right water. And he had a very keen eye on the guy in the far left of that barefoot line. Who was that, Michael?
That was our anchor, the legend himself, Mr. Kenny Meyer, Showside.
Kenny Meyer is one of the good guys, and when they say 50 minutes, he's like, yeah, I think I was there for every single time.
Oh, and I see these guys coming in. They've been out in that rough water before. That is a trademark here on Lake Mary, right? Kick at the biggest white crab you can find.
recordings on our show site, though, it's one of the most challenging technically to see because of all the waves and the water and the wind and the rain and everything we've got here, which is also what makes us one of the most skilled teams when it comes to the tournaments.
Yep, that is very true. This is an excellent training ground. A lot of the teams that the Aqualites compete against me on rivers or lakes where it is a lot more calm most of the time. So this is definitely rough water training, which allows the Aqualites to be well at tournaments and foundations being all rough. Take it away, Mike.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, direct your attention to the left side of the show course over here. We're giving the skiers a bit of time for the water and threat to come down. You're going to see an act that reaches speeds in excess of 70 miles an hour. We've got three outbound legends behind the boat. When they come back to the show course, you're going to see coordination and synchronicity between drivers and skiers. A hand is going to go over the air and a left hand drops. Those skiers are going to fight extremely hard. And at the right moment, at the precise time, the boat driver is going to crank that boat and send these skiers all the way around that boat. Watch out, ladies and gentlemen, they're coming into the show course. Boat driver 10 is in the air. And the drop! And the drop!
Thank you.
absolutely fantastic. Not just an Aquanaut ballet line, but an alumni ballet line there.
And one of the cool things is these girls are going to practice once this week, and then they go out there, lock it out, land it, synchronize. It's like they've done this a few times before. But what do we got next coming up, Mike?
Well, Brian, if you take a look down the left-hand side, we've got a few more of our Aquanaut alumni legends, but hey, guys, where are your skis? Those don't look like the right size.
I think the clown's got it. Your skis are a little small. They're like the size of a...
They almost look like the size of a shoe. So I think that's what we're going to do. These guys are going to go out shoe skiing. Yes, that's right. We're going to go on a little tiny pair of shoe skis. That shoe ski's about, what do you think, about 1.5 feet long, maybe about 8 inches wide. And guess what, folks? There's no fin on the bottom of that ski. Allows these guys to twist and turn on the surface of the water, just like this horse guy coming in right now. That is Colin Barber with the shoe skis on the ground. Following right behind him, that's Daniel Weir and Andy Engel sliding it off the pier. Tom Rick puts a crowd around for the boys on the water. And now we got three more guys coming off down the left-hand side. I believe we've got Jim, Pete, and Kevin. You know, it's kind of funny when you get to see inside the water skier's brain, like that one out there. In his mind right now, he is throwing Dana at the net. Well, I was thinking, you know, the sliding dock start is the hard part of the trick. That is definitely one of the reasons why I'm up here an announcer instead of a skier, you know. And the cool thing about shoe skis is it's not just the size of a shoe, it's what you can do on a shoe on a leg. Coming up in the leg right now, they're showing you how they can turn around front to back. Graciously show you how physics is an integral part of water skiing. I think he has some ropes and handles tight at his shoe skis there. You guys, now we got Andy and Dano. Look at that synchronized turn. Dano by himself walks it front to back, back to front. Mr. Showmanship, Andy and Mir.
And then Swift for a little back swan, showing you how low you can go.
Colin with an overhead and a line snap. Great job. Hey, look at that. No hand is well. He's a Colin Barber.
Shoe skiing's kind of a better edge thing. Yeah, if you haven't got a shoe, it's kind of fun. The problem is your margin for error is about this big. We call it catching in the hatch. You can see the result. You have just a small amount of weight distribution on the water. So as soon as you just do your weight the wrong way, you go catching in the hatch. And if you don't do it, you can do something like this over the water.
This guy grew up watching some of the best shoe skiers on the planet. One more to be left in. And with the showmanship, Mr. Danny Amir.
And now there was one.
Down to the right hand side, but the guys trying their best out there doing a great job. We got Kevin and Pete. And come in and watch this guy, Collins, this shoe ski flip through.
The fact that Colin even tried that is impressive enough because when they water, it's what they call wavy, which is a water skier's first drum.
Wait for Colin.
Stroke, stroke, stroke. Now we're going to show you on full display how well true skiers can swim when they're not on the water. If you look out right now, Kyle, you saw him over the water, but look how impressive he is in the water.
Oh, how about this? Don't look inside. Let's not forget about Mr. Bowman.
The Dunsman family lineage. He's one of the best sky skiers in the entire world. He goes up for a huge rock. You can hear him. Takes some time. It's a Cody Coffey. Another front person. Boys on fire. He's one of the best sky skiers in the entire universe. Combined with Andre Dunsman Coffey and the Dunsman family is what inspired me. There's so many others out here. But I just want to give a quick shout out to everyone in the crowd tonight. You guys are electric tonight. We're feeling it. We're show skiers. And it wouldn't be a show without you guys. So thanks a lot.
Swag to give away tonight. Got a lot of trivia here. How about this? Who in the audience knows?
Hey, wait a minute.
Hey, you guys. What?
We want that boat. We want to take the boat. We want to go for a ride.
You shouldn't even be on the pier.
No,
you can't have the boat. No.
We want the boat for sure. Let's go and talk to these guys over.
I don't want to talk to these guys. These guys are messing up our ski show flow.
No. There's no flow. There hasn't been any flow. The only flow I know sells insurance.
Let's cut it out. So, hey, look through the door out there.
Hey, look through the door out there.
Wait a minute.
What do you mean? People go in and out of doors. What are you doing?
Well, you should be out of here right now. It's out here in general.
I'm in here.
You are, you're bad. You guys are nonsense. You're both time wasters.
We're bad. If you guys know how to ski, maybe we can put you on the water if you know how to ski.
Oh, we know how to ski.
Oh, yeah.
Well, there's a bunch of boats in here that want to see skiers, not what you guys are doing.
Hey, look at this. Look at this.
Is that Kaylee Cord?
Yeah. Look at this, Kaylee.
Hey. All right, what you doing out? You're walking out there. Get your
hands
up up here.
Yeah. Woo! Hey. Hey. Hi. What are you doing?
I'm ready to barefoot water ski.
Barefoot water ski? What barefoot water skis? You ever hear someone with barefoot water ski? There's no barefoot water skiing. What's behind the door?
I don't know.
Let's take a look.
Ladies and gentlemen,
nothing is here! Nothing is here!
I want to see what's in there.
You do?
The award for the world's greatest barefoot water ski.
Well, that must be me!
I think it's Kaylee, not you.
You? No. Let's go see.
Help her pick the award, fellas. Come on, she deserves
here
it.
Here, go. Boost to Kaylee.
The award goes to Kaylee. We just heard it.
Oh! Oh, no. That was so mean. Ariana, help her out, please. Your sister Ariana's coming out to help her out. And who are you? Ariana. Help your sister out. Oh, no. So, Ariana,
forward, he's got a pie in the face. Do you think it's you, a pie in the face?
Hey, buddy, you want to call security, get these clowns out of here. They gotta stop harassing him.
Security!
Oh, hey, come on now, guys. Get off the show here.
Well, we're trying to get really surprised away from those clowns. Well, the rope's coming up.
Hey, wait, what are you thinking you're doing?
Beautiful water skiers!
What? Watch the donation now, ladies and gentlemen. The free driver and skier, Bob Kohler. Our driver is going to take his job from Jesse's.
I'm an announcer, this guy. before we awesome folks, ladies and gentlemen, the Aquanauts are so proud to present to you tonight the special 50th anniversary treat. To all of you around my left and around my right, and boy, oh boy, we got a special second half and a special evening. And perhaps one of the greatest things about Trust Game is that fundraising seems to revolve around sunny weather, drinking, and food that isn't good for you. So, coming through the audience right now, a bunch of our skiers with buckets and programs. Ladies and gentlemen, we depend on your support in order to fund the Aquanauts. There are lots of ways to support it. Coming through, like I said, a bunch of skiers with buckets. Please drop your 5s, 10s, 20s, 50s, 100s. If you have a $500 bill, I won't buy it from you for $1,000. You have a $1,000 bill, I'll give you $2,500 for it. But ladies and gentlemen, we need your support. If you don't have cash, well, you can text the word Ski Show to 44321. That's the word Ski Show to 44321. You'll get back in money. If not, you can grab a program. There's a PayPal QR code there where you can just hold up your camera and you can go make a donation there. So, how are we doing out there tonight? Let me hear a crack it. Can you hear me? All right. Didn't even notice there's a beer tap down there. That's from the Chamber of Commerce. Did you notice that there's a band up there? Orchestra 33. If you've never heard of them, they're one of the best. Get the cards. Get the cards. Hire them for their weddings or their other parties. The town on the stage will be that. And I'm waiting for a couple of people. Waiting for Justin Mitchell. Oh, and the trophy, and Lisa. And Carl, where's Carl? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to the people out here on the stage. First, can I get your attention? Alright, because we're doing a little presentation here. First, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to our 2022 show directors who just brought home, show everybody, hello, the 2022 Wisconsin State Championship Trophy. To their right, or your left, that's Carl Schubert. He was the first show director in 1972. That's Sam Cookman. She is the executive director for Kenosha County. To her right, we've got Joe Janis, the chairwoman of the Twin Lakes Chamber of Commerce. Tim Hodgman, the Chamber of Commerce. To that right, we've got Kent Younger. Yeah, you know who it is. And president of the Aquanauts, Mr. Bob Cole. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, while you're doing a donation, if you would, please keep it down for just a second. I'm going to give the mic to Sam for a little presentation here.
Hello, everybody! It's great to be out here. I am Samantha Kirkman. I'm your con exec, and I grew up just about a mile or two from here, and it is such an honor for me to be here to celebrate 50 years of Aquanaut skiing here in Twin Lakes. I'm a new timer, only about 3 months, and some of the special things that I get to do are come to events like today and to celebrate the community, celebrate families, celebrate multi-generational, just good entertainment. Since I grew up here, I grew up with many skiers, and it's really, truly an honor for me to be here to help celebrate their accomplishments. Oh, hey, Howard. Everybody knows who Howard Skinner is, the village president. Again, Let's give him a warm round of applause. Howard Skinner. And as I was saying here on stage, how it's grown. The first shows were held at Edgewater Beach, just over there, the first 8 shows. It grew to over here the next season, where you see what the Aquanauts and the community built. And it's truly an honor for me to be here to celebrate Aquanauts Water Show Day here in Kenosha County. And I have an executive proclamation that whereas in 1972, the Aquanauts Ski Show was formed by Gary, Carl, and Kent, and whereas the team performed the first 8 ski shows at the Edgewater Beach in 1973, it moved to an existing site at Lance Park. And whereas the first team was choreographed, first team to use choreographic and pectronics in the show, the crack the whip transfer of the ropes from one boat to another, and was to do the 7 loop skiers around the boat. And whereas it successfully defended its 2021 state title on July 24th, where it took first place at the state ski show. In 1977 to 1979, also took first place at the state ski show. In 1982, won national title. And then the triple count skiing 2 years in a row in 1983 and 1984. So I, Samantha Kirkman, do proclaim today, Aquanaut Water Show Day, given under my hand, July 30th, 2022. So again, congratulations and look forward to another 50 years down here at the beach.
Thank you, Sam. Thank you very much. Bob, I'll have you, you present that to Bob Kohler, our team president. And next up, another introduction. Many of you know Tim Hodgman and Joy Janice. Joy is like, she's like everybody's aunt here in Twin Lakes, all right? Joy is one of the sweetest, kindest ladies, works here, lives here in Twin Lakes, and Joy's got something she wants to share as well.
Thank you, everybody, for coming out. And as Samantha said, congratulations, Aquanauts, on 50 years. And that's what brings us here to celebrate. And Jim and I, as part of the chamber, would like to present the Aquanauts with a little certificate as we celebrate their 50th years and a little cash donation on behalf of the Twin Lakes Area Chamber. Congratulations.
Thank you, Joy. Thank you, Tim. And last but not least on the presentations, Bob O'Neill, our first announcer. Boy, and he's still got the pipes. You know, you coming back next year?
Maybe we'll come back. We'll never know. You never know.
Well, Bob,
you've done a great job already, my friend.
Yeah, thank you, Bob.
Let's give it up for this guy right here. Mark Gruner, the national champion, the state championship announcer for the Aquanauts. Fantastic job.
Thank you.
All right, so one more. Mary, who's this from? All right, so team is a special award for the 3 founders. There's a picture of them all barefooting together. Gary Borowski, Kent Yunker, and Carl Schuber. So we're going to present that to them right now. If someone could present this to Ted Borowski, he's in the crowd. Mary, can you read this to Ted? And Ted is here also. All right, let's go to Ted. Let's also thank our original advisors, which are right in front of you right now. Ted Borowski, Don Calvert, and Sandy Adams. Well, Carl's got something special for you, too.
Well, if I talk about this too much, I'll break up. So, yeah. We didn't get here without a lot of help, you know. Parents, families, the village took a chance, had a bunch of kids, and they paid off though, right? Both ways. So, big supporters,
all the village services, the police department, fire and rescue, lots and lots and lots. And you guys, the fans. Let's have a round of applause for all the Aquanoid fans. I want to point out something, though, in our structure. The oldest of us were like 18 and 19 when we started. Everybody else was younger. Okay? So we had a group of senior advisors that got this thing going as much as we did. And we had the originals were Bud Weber, Geraldina, Ed Kesey, Sandy Adams, Don Till. I want to talk about Don and Ted just briefly. These guys had a very deft, subtle hand. Nobody ever came up to me and said, hey, you need to put my kid in the show, or you need to do this. We sat in our first board meetings, board of directors meetings, with their guidance, once again, sitting back, letting us do the work. And they started us off with our first Hydrodyne, a loan from Don Sr.'s father for two engines for the Hydrodyne, and all sorts of help along the way. And that includes Sandy and everybody. So I have, can I get closer? I have a little gift for Don and Ted. These are exclusive. Nobody else has these. These are special edition 50th anniversary jackets. Exclusive, there's no other kind. This one says Don. 50th anniversary logo. And this one is Ted's. Thank you both.
Yeah, if I just may tell a small story. Ted and I lived on the same lake, on Lake Elizabeth. And we came back from water skiing or whatever, my wife and I. And there was a boat out in the middle of the lake, and a guy was paddling with one of the skis. And it was Ted. That's how we met him. His boys had run the boat out of gas. And that's how we met him, and we started to talk. And I thought, well, that was the end of it. But 2 weeks later, we pulled them in again because they ran out of gas. So that started the friendship that we built up, and we built up over the years since 1970. And our kids have all skied, and we've all had kids on the team. So I got to just thank the village of Twin Lakes for their patience with us, because at one point in time, the police department had my phone on speed dial because of the kids in the team that were doing not such nice things. And then I also want to thank the police department, the fire department, and the rescue squad for always being here for us. And I think that the city realized what we were when we had to have the police department take the traffic out of the parking lot. And then I think we got realized, or then they realized that, hey, this is something good. And then we had a lot of fun going to meetings and talking to people and moving along and getting the site that we got. So thank you all for coming. Thank you all to the alumni. Thank you everybody on the pier. And I appreciate it very much, and I'm glad to be here.
Thank you all so much. Thank you to our alumni. Garrett Adams out there, one of the leaders of the alumni. We got a second half to do. I hope you had enough time to fill the buckets with cash and fill your tummies with beer and pizza. Check out those food trucks out there. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in just a minute or two. Wrap the ropes. Make sure last call for the concessions up there. And we can't wait for the second half of the show.
Thanks to Sam Copeland from Kenosha County. Thanks to the Chamber. Thanks to all of you for helping us win the state title. We couldn't do it without you. And one way you can help support the Aquanauts is by having a nice cool set. Orchestra 33 will be rocking in about a little over an hour. They'll go for almost 3 hours. Wow, what a beautiful day. Thanks so much. We're doing our final world laps and then throw it back.
Seats, because we're going to start in about 3 minutes, since I was told 2 minutes ago, 5 minute warning. So 3 minutes, please get back in your seats. So this might be an odd question tonight, and I'll look around. Is anyone out there seeing their first ski show ever in the crowd tonight? A few hands. Well, you guys picked a good one to come to. I hope you're enjoying it. Show skiing obviously is a fantastic sport since we've been around for 50 years. As you guys saw earlier, 3 generations out there on the water. Many parents skiing with their sons and daughters. It is a great, great family sport. It's also a sport that you can enjoy if you're not a skier. You can help out in the sound booth. You can talk on a microphone. You can sew costumes. You can ride in a boat. You can drive a boat. You can build backdrops. Really, if you have a talent, a show and ski team can use it. And Wisconsin, Illinois, the Midwest, is the hotbed of show skiing. Wisconsin is actually its own region for tournaments. There is, if you can believe it or not, there's actually 50 show ski teams in the state of Wisconsin. So they are all over the place, and then there's a few around the Illinois region as well. I don't know if it was mentioned tonight earlier, before I got here, but congratulations to the current Aquanauts who finished first in the state of Wisconsin in their tournament last weekend. First place in back-to-back years, that's fantastic. I think Justin Wiesel around here with that trophy. Tournament show skiing, if you don't know, is a very different animal than the skiing you see here. In tournament show skiing, the team is given 20 minutes to set up, 1 hour to put 13 acts on the water, and 10 minutes to tear down. You are judged on the difficulty of your skiing, you are judged on the announcing, you are judged on your sound, your towboat driving, your pickup boat driving, you are judged if you have a knot in your rope. It is a tremendously difficult tournament to win, and again, the Aquanauts of one state in back-to-back years. So just a few more minutes, sit back, relax, and we'll be right back.
Fantastic.
Let's get up the crowd. Come on, you guys. Great job.
Thanks for coming on.
I can't get the music. It's really
and it's not the one celebrating. We all do what we do at home, and not only but what makes it a show is the support of the audience and the enthusiasm of coming out and doing something to entertain. So even on our 50th anniversary, many of you have known us for 50 years, and really, really appreciate the support. Thank you.
So I know we just mentioned some of the opera that's been here and that been from the beginning and out here, and the quarterback back of opera members that passed away over the years. But we didn't want to make it dark by going through all every single name and everything else. But there are three that I'm compelled to mention in the beginning of this whole thing with me and Carl and Kent. I just want to mention them again. But this show would not be here without Gary Borowski.
Yeah.
Gary Borowski was the one with Carl Kent, but actually Gary Carter was. Him and John Dunlop, he learned about show scaling from the Knucklebats. But Gary's passion and dedication to build this team with Carl Kent was what made this grow. And I also want to mention his brother Greg. Greg Borowski was the funniest clown in the history of show scaling. Sorry, Kent. Sorry. But the name of Kent and Kenny were fantastic. But Greg Borowski was the most charming, funniest person in the world. We miss him every day. And the other last person who's right next to me as well, sorry with me, was Brian Shuffle, Brian the Shark Shuffle. Brian, in the first years of the Outlaws, Brian was kind of a big flag. He's a flag line on the end of holding flags. He was in a pickup boat. And then when Gary left the team and 79 and 80, everybody's freaking out. What are we going to do? Who can drive the boat like Gary Borowski? Gary is an absolute legend in the higher line. So Kenny Borowski and I talked about it, and we pulled Brian Shuffle out of the pickup boat. Almost every team member thought we were crazy. How would you think that kid would be qualified to drive the main towboat in our shows? Well, Brian Shuffle not only learned, he became a multi-time national championship boat driver. So let's give it up one more time. Gary Borowski. Gary Borowski. And our good friend, all these other guys. Brian Shuffle. Brian the Shark. Thank you.
In the spirit of 50 years in the past, we're in the present, and we're about to move into the future. In fact, DJ, what's going on over here? I know. Yes, I know. That's why I said, DJ, what's going on over here? You guys don't have walkies. You can't hear me. So he's like, no, we've got to get out of the show. Yes.
Well, I think it's suicide, though, right? Suicide?
Well, we're not committing suicide.
No, we may be
career suicide.
That's right. Maybe career suicide.
I'm not committing suicide.
So suicide crisscross, we'll give a little space here. Let's talk about suicide. Scatter lines.
Would you start an ad for more depressing sentence? What's talking about suicide?
That came out wrong. That came out wrong.
But let's talk about the suicide crisscross.
Yes, that little scattered lines. And each man cuts underneath each man. If one guy falls, you're going at 40 miles an hour. It's that blade in the back of the skis could cut you open like sushi. Very dangerous.
That is just a little ray of pitch black today, isn't it, about the suicide?
Cut it out now.
This is what you get when you take it all to 3 a.m. Here's what you're going to see next, ladies and gentlemen. It is a cool, but it's a little crazy if you're on the way. It goes off. What's going to happen?
You see these guys beating back and forth. Let's watch it, folks. Timing is everything. One man falls, it could be disaster. The lines are staggered. Here they go. Back and forth. Ladies and gentlemen, weaving, bobbing, cutting, and carving the awkward suicide crisscross team.
Now, it looks like a good motion. But when you're in the suicide crisscross, there's a little thing called you get cracked, because if one of those guys doesn't look the rope, your crack goes right into it. It is not your crack. That's the name of suicide. Put your hands together here and now, upside down, inside out, over, under, around, and through. Flying.
Suicide crisscross team!
Oxygen!
oxygen.
Oxygen.
Everybody got oxygen. That's exactly. Uh-oh. Speaking of oxygen, this takes me back.
We found the gold. We found the gold.
We found gold. Is there gold in them there in waters now? As I said, Aquanauts put the show in show scheme. What exactly that mean? That means truly before show scheme, there was just scheme. And how did that change, Mike?
Ladies and gentlemen, let's flash back because 1982 was the very first year the Aquanauts did a theme show, and that theme show was the Saga of Rock Ridge.
Oh, we're not at a state water ski tournament. My bad. Okay. I think we've given you guys just enough time to make it calm to give you a fight. Okay, go ahead. Try shocking him back to life. Wait a minute. That Pat Coffee? That is Pat Coffee. You're going to definitely need. Does anybody have an IV? Oxygen. All right. See, we are a dumb bunch of animals, but we're pretty good. Once he gets off the gear, your problem is these three guys don't have any skis. Probably not a lot upstairs either. But that's what makes a great first ever performance at this and invented here. It's called the Flying Duck. Barefoot Star. Pat, the audience wants to see you do that again. Pat, the audience
Prince wants it. Okay, well, let's give Pat a moment to catch his breath and then drink the water. But as long as you're looking in that direction, look to the right. Three guys, each one has two pairs of skis. That's it. Now. That's beautiful, man. It's best, man. It's really beautiful. Speaking of I know. We want to see if I got to do it again. Pat, thank you very much for being resuscitated by Bob Bono. One of the coolest things you see on JS County in Delaware is that flying dog barefoot start. A little backstory to that. It was invented by a guy, Gary Grosky. Gary was the first one to go, you know what, guys? What did he do? This guy's going to tell you about it. His name is Andy Amore, and that's Mark Gurdon. You're right now, very strategically figuring out what are we going to do next. Well, you know, Mark, I think I like to stand there and put my hands in my pocket and put my hands. Mark said, well, you know, Andy, I think you're better at Mark than I am. And Andy said, well, it's impossible. And now we're talking about, it's a swivel, right? Why don't you stand over there in your blue shirt, I'll stand here in my red shirt, but we'll keep talking while the audience looks at us. That's right, there's a big debate going on, but take a look down the left-hand side, because what starts right now is one of the most exciting acts in all of show speed, and it starts tonight with six of our ballet line. I mean, what makes this ballet line a little bit special?
Well, that's right, Mike. Check this out. All those girls are going to get out there on the water. And they're not just going to go around all nice and smooth, hold on to that hand. They're going to get their feet right into that throne hole. Right around. And nothing but a few. Let's watch.
So take a look at this, folks. What starts is six going forward. But it's quickly going to turn because they are on a swivel binding. And they are going to go unbraced. And they are going to turn all the way around. Circle that makes it a ballet line. But what makes it incredible is down the left hand side. Because you can see right now an Aquanaut original is getting prepared. Skiers on the dock and skiers on the bottom.
All right, folks. This act is done this year. This is one of our highest scoring acts. If you've never seen it before, get your cameras out. Get your videos going. Because this is tough to believe. And as we told you earlier, don't try this at home, even if you can. Take a look down the left-hand side. There's Bob Porter, 750 horsepower. Inside that boat, he's got a couple of assistants. There's a big pole in the middle of that boat. And look at the pier. It's split in half. There is margin of error about 1%, maybe 14 inches on each side. Here comes Bob Kohler. Get your cameras ready. He's threading the needle. He's safely through. Are you guys watching? Here it goes. The ropes are hooked. The leaders are set up. We think we're okay. Wait a minute, we threw one. But ladies and gentlemen, we got the six-girl bypass. All right, are we going to try it again?
Do you guys want to see that again?
No, you don't.
Do you want to see that again, MT?
No, I don't want to see that again.
What do you want, Michael?
I want to see him make it.
Yes!
Come on, guys. This is the oldest joke in show skiing.
Are we going to ask you again?
You want to see that again? It's usually because something fell. So the answer is no, I don't want to see it again.
I want to see him make it. So, one more time. Do you want to see that again?
That was horrible.
What do you want to see?
That's what I heard.
All right. It looks like the guns are loaded. Folks, ladies and gentlemen, popcorn stick.
Maybe make the margin of error not so small this time, Mark.
One turn. Maybe we should have made up. Give popcorn an extra 3 inches per side. Are you watching? Like I said, one of the most dangerous acts. The boat can go in, the girls can go in, but it's not going to happen. Okay. Big chew when Bob Kohler threads that needle. Let's hear it. Here he comes. The boat is through. Ladies and gentlemen, there he is. 16 inches of margin on each side. The ropes are set. The leaders are winding tight. The loops are out. At six, he comes. 17.
Second time, drop the
job, ladies, indeed. Please take care of that guy down there. Oh, no. Bobby, what's
I gotta deal with these guys again?
Where I'm at.
I can't believe it.
What the heck?
Alright, what are you guys doing? What's going on here, guys?
You put us on the water, we put two together, and there's a four.
Yeah, we'll show you how it all started and how it's all going.
Who do we got out there, Andy?
We got Carl.
Now,
Carl out there.
That's right, the guy who started in the Aquanauts part of the original three. He didn't just do things off the water. He was a very good steer on the water.
That's right, and he's still out there pushing the envelope right now at the... I don't know, 50 years after we started. The hardest part about coming back down here and skiing, like for me earlier, I had to undo my life jacket just so I could bend over to put my feet in the bottom. So,
that happens. And before we go too far, we didn't get a chance to actually formally introduce you, because you're like, oh, this guy was water skiing, and now he's here holding up. He's what we call a two-way water skier, which means he can go on the water and on the water. Excellent announcer, his name is Andy Amore. His family has been involved forever. And now joining us here off the water. And now we're going to show you next is coming over. Those guys are wearing that wakeboard. Cool and hard thing about wakeboards is it has a very distinct long head.
Well, let's just talk about some of the wakeboarders that are down here. That's right. Legendary wakeboarders. Some of the best in the business ever. Eric Ruck. And for one tournament, Mr. Shane Bonifay. That's right, one of the best in the business. But right now, we're going to get out here on the water. We're going to get Carl going. Make some noise. The first show director in Aquara history about to hit the water right now. He can hear you, so let me hear you. And make some noise as we welcome to the water. That's the worst part about getting in the water right there. He just naturally sucks the ender.
And the second better
not mention that again.
That's a knock.
Yeah. There you go.
Well, as long as this gives us a little more moment, I wanted to. One of the coolest accomplishments that's behind the scenes in Aquanaut Water Shows. Before Aquanauts, water skiing involved just water skiing. You would not have heard any music at all. You would not have seen any costumes at all. You would not have seen any themes at all or any dancing. Now there is not a water ski show in the world that you don't go see today that includes costumes, themes, dancing, and music, and it all started right here on this lake. The first team though, we are not just going to water ski, we're going to entertain. Is that enough, Phil?
We're going to roll the mat. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Carl! All right, back down to the main show here. We're going to make some noise with this next guy. His name is Eazy-E Ethan Shulba. We're going to bring him out there on the wakeboard. Check this out, folks. He's going to take a huge cut right off the bat. There he is with a huge air rally. Ethan, one of the best wakeboarders in a long line of wakeboarders down here at Aquanaut. It's like I said, Eric Ruck. Shane Bonifay, Andy Amore, Jason Lynch, those last two, not so much. We'll get back to the game, so let's put Comrade right now out there charging. Doing a great job. PG area, give it up for Carl. We're back on down to your right-hand side. Ethan's not done yet. We saw that huge invert. The air rally coming in right there with a nice little half-cat roll. Into a roll the revert. Coming back through, that's a scarecrow. One more time from the other side. They call that a frantrum. It's a mix between a tantrum and a muscle. And they throw it in with a nice old toe side front roll right there at the end. He can hear you. Give it up for Ethan. Carl's coming back in his footsteps, showing you truly how aquanauts and water skiers can form all the same time. Starting with this guy right here. Carl Schubert shows you where we started, and finally, Mary's footsteps showing you the present of where we started. Here you go, folks, from the left-hand side. Check out huge rolling bird out there. Ethan going great. He's bringing it back up to shore. Now these guys, they're anything but easy to get out of. So we have Carl is setting, giving him his due as soon as he gets back up here.
I don't like you.
The beginning of water skiing, this man Carl Schubert. The presence of water skiing, this man Ethan Shulba. Together, we make up the Aquanauts, the broadcast. Carl just reminded me, 68 years old, wakeboarding, setting the stage, setting the path. How old is he, Ethan? Anyone? 21? Oh, Lord. 68 followed by 21. That's rough. That's rough anything in a week, but we got to follow the footsteps of Carl. Only Ethan Chula can do that. Now, we're going to change things up a little bit, and I'm going to change things up a little bit, too. We got another act that truly encompasses all of the water skiers' talents all at the same time. And this man right here is going to come down front and center and give you a little insight into what you're about to see next. What?
Sure, Brian. So in show skiing, we affectionately call this act the Big Act. The Big Act because it gets just about every guy and every girl on the team out there on the water at the same time. Usually there's a mix of conventional doubles, trios, strap doubles, maybe some swivelers out there. But it's a place where we all start to learn to ski on the big show boards with a girl on our shoulders. That's called conventional doubles because you keep your hand firmly on the handle at all times. I believe we've got that first group coming out right now. Down the left-hand side, they are your Aquana alumni.
Tricky thing about water skis, they do great on water, but once you cross the skis of your neighbor, every time you see them slide out. Now those are the conventional doubles. Look down here, we got two girls, two guys, one girl on their shoulders. Together, they make up the Aquanet Trios.
So now in trios, and also down the left-hand side, you can see these guys as well, wearing a strap harness around their waist, allows them to keep their arms free of the girls in various positions. You're out there, strap doubles couple.
And the third part of the Big Act, as you can see, as you use all the darts working around. Following the footsteps, we got three rolling out of the buildings, and up the score.
Well, there's not much more that Brian and I can add to this act, so why don't you sit back with us and enjoy conventional doubles, trios, strap doubles, and the Aquanets roll on.
Coming in. score, 72 years old. Look at this guy. Greg Stroud. Greg Stroud.
Yeah.
Isn't that right, Rami?
Back to the basics.
Right here, here he comes, down on the metal, huge weight to weight 360. He was really taking it up a notch this past. How about this? I got his great helicopter wrapped up, spinning. He's wrapping up one more time from inside to out. Nice. 360 right there. After Anthony Falco and Jack, Steve Bosco was in there. Check this out. Inside the outflow, Ethan going down, screwing everything up. Wow, the crowd making funny out on the stage again, funny out here on the water. We're going to take back in a second, but check this out. Now it's coming in one more time. Stop it back there. Stopping it down. That leads us to Darren and Laramie. What's he doing on the way in? Do you guys want to see Darren go upside down?
See what happens. Huh. Where on earth did you get that heat?
Well, this car is automatic. It's systematic. It's hydromatic.
Here we go.
spot right in front of you.
I know this, Candy's probably not too happy with Bob right now. Bob was rocking the boat, Todd was driving like he owned it, I guess. These guys are talented, they're talented at Triple H, but Mike, we're about to the left, what do you got going on right now behind the inboard? Take a look down the left-hand side, because after that action, we're going to slow things down just a little bit, but increase the difficulty with our first school star, Mrs. Megan. Thank you.
how about three beautiful ladies doing a great job out there on the water. And beautiful smiles right back here on shore. We have Leslie, Ariana, and Maddie. And with some beautiful 720 degree spins out there on the water, let's welcome back Megan. And last, but certainly not least, doing an excellent job out there on the water, let's welcome back Tara. Great job, ladies. Now this is one thing we definitely, from all the years, recognize. It's a bar, but something's happened in Aqua Lore. Sometimes we skiers have a tendency to, well, we try to meet people, but sometimes they just lost that loving feeling. We're not just good skiers. Sometimes we are good singers, especially with women.
You all know the words. Come on now, audience participation. You're going to get a ribbon at the end of this if you sing.
Back in, or no, we're not.
We're going to bring that back in and hit that ramp one more time. Who wants to see it?
All right, we're adjusting real fast. Now I'm getting excited. We got three more jumps for you. All right, so over the years, the Astros have had a ton of very talented skiers. But now recently, the jumps have progressed and become more difficult. Now it isn't just about going out and doing a flip or doing a helicopter spin or doing a game. It's all about how do we make this more dangerous. I got an idea. Let me wrap a rope around my face, except I'm going to ride a rope that's 3 feet shorter than yours. We're going to hit the ramp at different times. Watch this. George Martin has got a rope wrapped around his waist. Cody Rocky on the outside. He's going to end up on the show side. It's happening. But now I'm going to take your attention back down to the right-hand side. Ethan Sherman went backwards with the gear. This time he's got the rope around his waist. It's the one, two, go.
It is black. You found it? Oh, I am actually looking for an iPhone 13 that's been lost. It's Michelle Cooks. Michelle, have you found it? I don't believe you have. But it is Michelle Cooks. And it is seriously lost. So if you find a black iPhone, you can either bring it to the sound booth, please. Or up by the beer tent, or give it to somebody that looks like they're an opponent. We all know who Michelle is when you give it to Michelle. That was a public service announcement.
That was a good news, everybody. Don't do your job.
We have a wallet! I'm missing a wallet by chance. And Katie's missing those as well.
Oh, we got a guy who looks very embarrassed.
Oh yeah, this is definitely you.
Sir, did you find a cell phone?
Did you find a phone?
No. That's unfortunate.
Yes. I already made sure there was no money left in his wallet.
So we're actually trying to kill a little bit of time, even though this guy's one of the best barefooters around.
I don't think he's going to kill anybody.
It still looks a little bit choppy. I think we do have some t-shirts that we could throw out into the audience. But it looks like they're ready right now, folks, and we're going to put a pause on that. Take a look down the left-hand side. We got Colin Barber. He's going to follow in the footsteps, and he's going to backwards barrel.
But now back on down to the right-hand side, you'll see that there is a triple rink down there. All posted up right next to the pink house, and you can see one head floating in the water. I can, you definitely can, because you're too far around the turn, whatever, it's a thing. But check this out, this time though, this guy isn't going to start with his face in the water. He's going to start on a ski. Watch this, all the way down to the right-hand side. George Hartman, he's going to give a quick count on his head. A little one, a little two, a little three, and flip that ski around. George Hartman's going to pick up the ski. He's going to plant the feet. What's the one break going to the cleanest back steps ever?
Cleanest. So Colin's what, probably 24?
27.
27?
See, you and I are old, man.
24 sounded cooler. George is
62.
62, and a grandpa.
And that is a clean step that I just saw, too.
And a very clean step, yes.
One of the cleanest.
All right, so I could probably get off the stage and give this back to another one of our announcers.
Anybody else?
Distinguished announcers here. We got a little, what? We got three mics. And we do want to give away some t-shirts. We do have a little bit of time before we close this out tonight.
We have a lot of time.
He needs to
so see Colin right there. He's got to go all the way down to the bar, put some skis on,
all right,
and come all the way back.
These four guys, give
us some skis if you want to.
Give it away for T-shirt.
Look at that guy up there. That guy got a shirt, and I see why.
Maybe popping out his button, sir. You look handsome. All right, so in all seriousness again, folks, 50th anniversary show. Who has had a good time tonight?
I know I did.
Who has had a great time tonight?
Who has had a better than great time tonight?
Well, we got one more act on the water, and then please join us for the rest of the night's festivities. We got a band playing in just a few minutes.
Orchestra 33, I've been told that multiple times by none other than the Trevier, is from Arturo. Excellent band.
So if you want to hang out with us, we're going to be hanging out for a few more hours at the end. But before we do the post-show celebration, everybody's going to take a little look far down to the left side. Because MT is about to tell you what's coming before your eyes. So ladies and gentlemen, if you have your cell phone on you, please take it out now because this is the most photographed act in all of show skiing. Take a look down the left-hand side because they are building it up right now with current skiers and Aquana
locking out. Girls climbing the third tier, and then a few more final steps. Too high.
Yeah. Jim Walker.
Jim Walker.
Mark Murdoch. You see him 27 on Saturday night, too. And the guys who put this alumni show together, I'd like to introduce you to Sean Randy Bridge. He spent so much time last year just to get us where we are. First, right over here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for all of our chair directors. We have Garrett Adams, Ken Schumer, Leslie Braun, Eric Fowl, Lisa Kahn, and Lisa Boyd. So let's give it up for DJ. LaTerry Michael. And thank you for everybody who came down here. My name is Andy Amor. We had a great time tonight. But before we leave, there's one more thing to do, and that's dance.
The only mistake we made tonight. What I like about you, please. Hang on. What's y'all, huh? Thank you for coming tonight. You made the 50th amazing. Here we go!
If you're all skiers, please go out to the main piano for a team pick.